So welcome back to Orchid House. I'm Olivier and today I wanted to talk about mites and Catasetums. Mites are a problem for a lot of orchids, but they are a particular bane for Catasetums because the Catasetums have very tender leaves and the mites love them. So this is now peak season, so I have a bunch of Catasetums in blooms or in spikes. There are spikes everywhere, so it makes things a little bit more complicated. So mites typically thrive in dry and hot weather. So for us here in South Florida, it means spring is perfect for them. They love it. So during the spring, I try to keep the population down as low as I can. And I use systemic and I use chemicals. This time of the year, except for one of my chemicals, I really can't use them because they're going to damage or kill the buds or the blooms, so I have to use more softer means. Now the good news is that it's still hot, but it's humid and the mites don't like it as much. So I'm going to show you two things that I'm doing with my Catasetums. I don't have a really big problem anymore with the mites, so it might be a little tough to show you, but I mean, basically, you're going to have a pretty good idea of what I'm trying to accomplish. So this one, again, to the cracks, I mean, there's stuff here. There's some sap. I mean, that's typically indicative of mites as well. So what I'm going to do for this one, I'm going to use isopropyl alcohol, 70%, with a Kleenex. And so I'm going to moisten my Kleenex real good and make sure that it doesn't hit any buds, because that's going to kill your buds right away. And then I'm just going to wipe the leaves inside as well. There's a lot of the mites like to go inside your leaf axils. It's kind of a nightmare. I mean, there's a lot of stuff here. Trying to get to the sticky stuff. Let me see. Right here. What I also do sometimes is just spray directly on the leaves, but if there's a strong infestation, then your leaves, you see a lot of damage. You see a lot of translucent spots. There's not a lot really, but yeah, okay. So another way of doing this, like I said, you can spray. That's also gonna knock down. I mean, they get killed on contact with the alcohol. But it's not a systemic, so I mean, all it does, whatever gets hit, and you see, I mean, you have a better idea of the damage. You see it, you start seeing translucent spots. So there's damage to the leaves. Now, another way which I use now, especially with, you see, for instance, this one has a spike, so I can't even use the alcohol, it's too dangerous. Let me use, you see there's a bit of sticky sap there, and I'm gonna again use the alcohol and just wipe it. Where was it? Right here. Yeah. So the damage here is not that big, but you still see a discoloration on the leaf. Now, what I like doing this time of the year, I'm gonna spray the leaf. So you have to use a very soft spray because these are tender leaves. At first I used something harsher and then I just blew up my bulb. It just broke off. So you have to be gentle. But so this is a mist setting. And all you do here is knock off the mites. They fall off. Doesn't even kill them, although I guess once they are on the ground, they're not going to survive much. I do it also inside, but you have to be careful because sometimes you're going to have rot. So you want to really try to get as much of the moisture out of there. But I mean, this is a gentle way of doing things. Once you have buds and flowers, and again, all it does is knock them off. But what you want, I mean, you're not going to get rid of your mites. They are around. And so what you want is to keep the populations under control. I had a big problem 4 years ago, and I had a lot of leaves that were devastated. And I promised myself I would never let it go that far. Now, the good news, even if you have, if it gets out of control, these guys, they go dormant in the winter. They are leafless, and then you start fresh the next year. So you get a redo, and then you can do better the next year. So just quick little tip regarding mites. Thank you very much. Have a good day. Bye-bye.